Hello everyone, this is Damon with PicSnub Software. In this video, I'm going to be doing a quick overview of FaceCrop version 3 to help get you started. When installed, FaceCrop 3 will be under the new plugins menu for CC 2021 or higher. You can put the user interface anywhere you want into the Photoshop workspace. You can actually dock it into the workspace. You can put it into the little pop-out menu as well. There are three main sections to the user interface. The first section is the section to create and test presets. And this is where you'll create the presets that you'll then run in batch. Now, it comes with 5 presets to start, but you'll probably want to make your own. If you select any of the presets, it's going to put the settings into the menu here, and I'm not going to go over what all of these settings do in this video. I've got another video dedicated to that. I'm just going to do a quick demonstration though. So you can then type in the settings you want, and once you have the settings to what you want, you can click the test preset button, and this is going to run a crop and show you how that preset is going to crop your images. And once you're happy with your preset, you can then run that preset on a batch of images after you save it as a new preset. So if you've changed your values, you'll need to save a new preset. So I'll do that right now. I'm going to call this my preset. And once it's saved, it's now in the drop-down menu. We see it here. So I'm going to select a different one just to change the values. And if I go back to my preset, you can see it puts in those values that I just entered. Now with the presets, you can run those on either algorithm. There is actually 2 algorithms for FaceCrop. I discussed this in a lot more detail in the video dedicated to this, but let's do a quick demonstration here. Right now we use the face to top a subject, so that's going to align the person from the chin to the top of the subject, and it puts 3 guides onto your image when you've tested your preset. The vertical guide is the center of the head, the bottom guide is the chin, and the top guide in this case is the top of the subject, which can be the top of their head unless they have a cap on, like in this case, or a bow or tall hair, and in that case it'll be the top of the subject. If I select head only and test the preset, it's going to align the person within that same space because that space is based on these numbers. However, in this case, it aligns the chin to the top of the head, or at least where it thinks the top of the head is. It's just guessing because you can't actually see the top of the head behind this cap. And just to demonstrate one more time, if I go face to top of subject, it's going to put the person into that same space, but it's going to use the top of the subject. Now, you can use the same preset for either when you batch, but just know that if you are running like cap and gown images, you may need to adjust the settings differently than if you're running a head-only algorithm. Anyway, I do discuss all of these in a lot more detail in another video, so watch that video. I'm just going to move on and do the demonstration here. So the manage presets, this is just where you can select a preset and delete it. For instance, I'm just going to grab this one and delete the preset. Now you see that number 2 preset is gone. You can export or import presets, which I'm not going to do in this video. And then you can restore factory presets. And that will restore the factory presets 1 through 5. But it did not delete my preset. It only restores factory presets. It doesn't delete your custom presets. You would need to use the delete all or delete individual presets to do that. The last section is the batch processing section. And this is where you will batch process your presets on a folder of images. You can run up to 4 presets in batch, and it would give you multiple crops. So you can get up to 4 different finished crops from each image. For this video, I'm just going to do 1. You need to select a source and a save folder. And this is source folder is the folder that contains your images that you're going to crop. The save folder is where you're going to save the images. These other settings I discuss more in the batch process settings video. But for this demonstration, I'm just going to hit run. Oh, first you got to close the images. It won't let you process until your images are all closed. Now when I hit run, it's just going to batch process all of those images with the preset that I selected. All right, the batch processing has finished. And if we look at the images here, we can see that they are all cropped. And it had the spacing exactly the same in all the images. I'll view the extra large icons here. But you can see the top of that cap. I mean, it nailed the spacing perfectly on the top of that image. So even where the caps are raised up higher in this image and then flatter in this image, it still was able to find the top and maintain that proper spacing. Anyway, thanks for watching, and make sure to watch the rest of the videos because, like I said, I go over all of the settings in a lot more detail in the future videos, because this video was just a quick video to get you started.